Photoshop CS5 is definitely a major upgrade from Photoshop CS4. It brings a lot of new photo editing features to the table, as well as some enhancements to the current features. But CS5 also brings a nice addition to 3D within CS5 Extended. 3D text. In the past, if you wanted nice-looking 3D text, you would either have to create the text in a modeling application or an Illustrator, then import it into Photoshop. Now it can all be done within Photoshop itself. Now remember, you have to have the extended version of Photoshop in order for this feature to be available to you. Now let's start by creating a simple text layer. I'm going to make sure to select a nice large font so that I get the best results. It's also a good idea to space out your letters so that the extrusion doesn't overlap. To add spacing to your text, open up the character panel by clicking this button at the top. Then go ahead and increase the tracking until your letters are nicely spread apart. That's looking pretty good. Now we're ready to go. Head up to the 3D menu, down to Repose, then Text Layer. This box lets us know that Photoshop is going to rasterize our text, which means that after we apply our 3D effect, we will no longer be able to edit the font or base color. So if you want to make any last minute changes, do those before adding the 3D effect. Now that we're in the Repose window, you can already see that our text has been turned into a 3D model. And of course, Adobe has included a bunch of preset shapes and materials for us. Now, one little neat side note, if you have an Adobe account, you can actually download additional materials from their website to use on your text. As I click through the different shapes, you'll probably see that it takes a few seconds to apply the adjustments. Unlike 2D editing, Photoshop needs a bit of time to render and calculate the 3D space. Down below, you can further adjust the depth of the extrusion, and you can also add a little bit of twist to your text. There's a lot you can adjust on your model: lighting, render settings, and the quality of the mesh. But the neatest thing is that because this is an actual 3D model, we can rotate it right in Photoshop. On the left, we have our movement and rotation tools. As I drag my mouse, you'll see that my 3D text is rotating. This is very cool. We also have roll, pan, slide, and scale. And once you're happy with the result, click OK to accept the changes. And that's that. 3D text in Photoshop CS5 Extended.